وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا.
You see how he is going to the jail. You know what he said? He said Islam says about the blacks. Yeah, the faces will be black and all that. Islam. And I show him in the book of Joel, it says the faces will be blackened. And he said, no, I'm not talking about Old Testament, I'm talking about only gospel. They say only gospel. He changed.
Action.
He did that. He did that. He did that.
You know, the discussion that you're having, I find it quite strange, doesn't it? Christians like yourself are very desperate to somehow find something in the Qur'an to prove the deity of the Spirit.
Look at this.
Very strange, because you can't prove the deity of the Holy Spirit in your Bible.
We can! What? Bible picks up from Genesis to Revelation that is one God in three persons.
So, as I stated earlier, we will continue, God willing, on this issue about the Spirit. But I want you to clarify why it's important is because once you make a claim, that if I make a claim, the Bible has millions of errors in it, and then I'm not able to provide even a single one, then it will be just what? A bogus claim.
Sir, remember our conversation.
You haven't made a bogus claim.
Our conversation started with the date of who is the Spirit in the Quran. Okay? So let's finish with that.
Then we can talk about that.
So let's finish with the Spirit and then we come to talk about how bad grammar in the Quran is.
No, not bad grammar. Provide us a list of
produce us a critical version of the Quran with all the grammatical mistakes that we can go and look at it. You need to stop telling people Quran is perfect with the grammar. So let's start with who is the Spirit in the Quran.
Allah's mercy.
You made a claim that there are millions of grammatical mistakes in the Quran.
I told you.
Not now.
When we finish, who is the Spirit? We will talk about it.
Not about it. I don't want to talk about it. I just want the list.
No, I'm not going to provide
you. You can provide an Excel file. I'll give you my USB.
I'm not going to do that. As a Muslim, you should be able to produce us a critical version of the Quran. And as a Muslim, you should produce us a book or things tell us actually those verses are perfect. With me. I gave you Surah 38 verse 45. You didn't even bother to look into that. So, let's start with who is the Spirit. According to the Quran.
I didn't look into it. The onus is on you to quote the text.
You didn't even bother to read your own scripture. It was so fearful of you. So, let's look at who is the Spirit. Okay? So
what are you saying, Last week
you told me that the Spirit and angels are the same thing.
last week you said you could speak Arabic.
Yeah.
Do you remember that?
Last week, did you say you speak Arabic?
Yeah.
Your dear Muslim brother lies. Just
I'm lying. Sorry? I'm lying.
Can you just...
Maybe she made it if time. If I spoke. So you don't speak Arabic.
Sir, can you just explain me? Can you just explain me? Who is the spirit and angels according to Surah 16 verse 2? Surah 16, 102.
No, one at a time. I can only do one verse at a time.
Sorry, who's got the Quran?
Can you just make sure your Muslim brothers are just knowing their boundaries?
Mansur.
That would be helpful.
As Qur'an. 16.
Bad if you state facts.
Okay, oh, Mushaf.
No, it's just. It's just got bent.
I hope it's. Oh, it's just English. But anyway, we'll refer to the Arabic.
Okay.
Okay, right?
Surah 16.
16, 1 or 2. Okay, go ahead. Make your point. Just 2.
Hatun, you can read Arabic and he can translate.
So, I'm at speaker's corner and I am using the common language Muslims use
But you talk about the Quran,
which is English.
Oh, you can't read Arabic.
If I need Arabic, that means
answer that question.
That Allah is very, very poor.
But you don't know the Arabic.
If you want to understand Quran, you must understand Arabic.
Why? Are you trying to say Paul Williams cannot be Muslim because he doesn't know Arabic?
Who said that?
No, that's not you.
Williams is not capable to understand the Quran because he doesn't know
Arabic? If you argue Quran, you must understand in Arabic too.
Some people who are converting Islam don't know Arabic.
I don't want to change the argument.
That's awesome.
This argument for another day. I didn't say that. You're putting words in my mouth.
Sir, we are at speaker's corner. Your Quran has been translated to English. There are thousands.
He's about to give you evidence, and he wants to know if you understand it in Arabic.
Sir, it looks like your job is for today to just record. Otherwise, you may be fired. Surah 16, verse 2.
So you don't know Arabic. That's fine.
He sent down the angels and the spirit of the his commanded until whom he wills of his born mankind, and there is no God to save me to keep your duty upon me. So according to this surah, this ayat, Quran, spirit and angels are different.
Okay, let's understand that. So according to this ayat, the spirit and the angels are different because... And the reason why they're different...
They're different, sir. Text says, he sent on angels with the spirit of his command unto whom he wills. Angels and spirits are mentioned.
Did you say his angels done with what?
Angels with his spirit.
Ah, in that one it says in angels with his inspiration.
That's the translator.
That's not Allah.
So basically his spirit is part of him, basically.
He's the translator, not Allah.
So, why don't we go to the Arabic?
Arabic word is... Arabic word!
You pointed out a very important point. Translations differ. So, can you just tell me what the Arabic says and why they're different?
Sir, just read the verse. What is the word
I'm not your master, Hatun. Don't call me
what is the What is the word for the spirit? What is the word for the spirit in Arabic? I'll help you. It is wrong. Okay.
No, let's look at it. Don't go.
Let's beyond, look at
it. No, I need to understand the point you're making.
So, I'm making this point.
In this ayah, you have the angels and you have the ruh. Right? Malaika and the ruh. And you are saying that they're different because
they're mentioned differently. I'm going to give you other reference, you can compare them. So go to the Surah 7, 97 verse 4.
Go one by one, but what I want to understand in principle is this.
Yeah, go to the Surah 97 verse 4.
This is the second reference. Within this first one,
sir, let me put in the context.
Surah Qadr.
Okay, go to the Surah 97 verse 4.
97
Surah Qadr, isn't it?
Qadr, isn't it? Yeah, it's not. It's not. It's not. It's not.
97 verse 4.
97. In the answer,
no. Verse 4.
Tell us a little bit like
complaining. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Go to the Surah 70 verse 4.
No, what is this 97 4 tells you?
Angels and the spirits descended therein.
And okay. What's the point from there?
There are two different things. There are two different things.
So just
Malak and Ruh. Go to the Surah 70 verse 4.
Slowly, Hatun.
It's just
no, no, one verse or ayah at a time. So this...
No, I'm going to give you four or five verses.
I don't want references. I want to understand the point you're making.
So I'm going
to
give you four or five verses, and then I'm going to tell you, those verses tells me angel and the spirit are different beings.
Okay, now I get you. Okay, so we'll come back to this reference. Can someone just remind?
Yeah. 70 verse 4.
Yeah, I got it.
Did you find it?
Yeah.
Angels and the spirit ascended unto him on the day thereof a span of 50,000 years. Surah 78 verse 37. 38, sorry.
78 verse 38.
نبأ. يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة في الصف لا يتكلمون إلا من الذين لا.
This is
28. No, 78. نبأ. You know this.
Okay.
Such a
yes.
يوم يقوم الروح
والملائكة. And the angels will stand for him. None shall speak except any who is permitted by most gracious. Go to Surah 89, verse 21 to 23.
89, 21 to 23.
Yeah. Because an angel is a secret, then it's a secret.
Yeah, 21 to 23.
Okay. When the earth is ground, atoms grinding, the Lord shall come with angels, rank on a rank. And hell is brought near on that day. On that day, man will remember, but how will the remembrance? Okay? So, that's Allah and angels. It's the same grammatical order.
Okay, it's nothing about the spirit. We were talking about the spirit, right?
You're talking about the spirit. So
you wrote a verse which has no spirit.
Yeah, you gave a reference, there's
sorry,
no Ruh there.
It's an irrelevant reference.
No, it's a relevant reference.
Where's the Ruh?
Because, do you believe Allah and the angels are the same? Okay, so when you made a claim, if you made a claim, angels and the spirit are the same, I will ask you, why then do you believe it is the same grammatical order? Why do you believe angels and Allah are different? Same, different, sorry.
Do you think Ruh has one meaning in Arabic?
Right, so you've got your
references.
From can you make some?
It's like teaching a Polish person that language.
The Qur'an talks about
these
two names.
The angels.
You assume because they are mentioned separately, then they must be
speaking.
You're supporting this with the Lord and the angels. The Lord cannot be the angels. Because the angel is the same, the Lord has to be angels. What? Do you know anything about the Quranic Arabic construct?
Yes, you need to learn criticize Arabic. We don't know it.
Right? You've raised an objection. You don't need to time it. You can take all time you need to, make your point. Give me the time to make my point.
I don't want you to give me time to write an essay.
You're not being fair, Hatun.
Hatun, if you haven't made your point. Go ahead, take your time, make the point.
No, I make my point. I'm waiting okay. your response.
Then allow me to make. Allow me to make.
He's trying to answer, not write an essay.
I'm going to give you 4 minutes because I talk a lot, so it's your turn.
If you feel that I'm giving you a lecture or an essay, then tell me so. This is time to stop. Ignore it. Not 4 minutes and 5 minutes.
Just make your point.
We're not agreeing with the time. I am going to give you as much time you need to make your point.
No, sir.
Give me enough time to make my point. So, not sir, need to give you a lecture.
Sir,
is that fair?
We are keeping the times. I don't write essay for you. You don't write essay for me. And we respect each other's time. So it's your time. Come.
If I don't finish in time, then I will ask you for extra 4 minutes.
Let me continue.
So I'm asking you in my time. When I ask, I expect you to answer. Not 4 minutes of silence.
No, sir. Just ask. Take your time and then respond. This is going to be an interactive discussion. I don't want to just talk
and you remain silent. And in your time, you totally avoid
Ignore and evade everything
I said. So what I'm saying is this. Are you familiar with construction in any language, Arabic included, because that's the discussion we are having, right? Where members of the same kind can be isolated for a specific reason within the same sentence. For emphasizing, for position, for rank, for elevation, for status. In the Quran, I am going to give you now one example. Maybe I'll give you two. Maybe I'll give you three. Maybe I'll give you four. Like you give me four, I'll give you four examples to refute what you just said. Your clarity understanding is totally wrong. So now, open up. Now, your time now, chance, to open up the Quran and then look at the verses one by one. Okay? Surah number 2, ayah 238. That's why I'm saying time is irrelevant, because you need enough time for to check. Now I'm not going to make my point. I'll give you four examples like you've given, and four examples I'll show you how you need to understand the construction of the Quran in terms of members of the same kind.
Oh, sorry, I was just stretching.
Two? Yeah? 238.
Mine's going live.
Oh, is it? Should I put my precious red button?
Yeah, she knows.
Yeah.
You want to see the words? Eh? You want to see the words? 2 1 3 8.
I never ever
do anything
like this.
Yeah.
Let me read it then. Can I make it clear? Hafidhu ala salawat salati wa salatul usta. I'm asking, is Arabic not sufficient?
We are in a speaker's corner. We are in a place where people speak English.
Let him finish.
So it says God the prayers and the middle prayers. So I'm asking you now, he's talking about prayers, and the middle prayers are not prayer, because first it's mentioned middle prayer, God your prayers, and then it says God the middle prayers. According to your logic, this middle prayer cannot be a prayer.
Yeah.
It has to be a different
absurd kind. Yeah.
But obviously this is absurd, because it's referring to prayer, but it's emphasizing a middle prayer. My example number 2, in Surah Rahman, Surah 55, Ayah 68. Fihima fakihatu wa nakhlu wa rumman.
Can you do it in English?
She doesn't understand.
Why is Arabic not sufficient? Because we are talking
because
about the Arabic.
Because I got the English translation of the Quran.
He's about to give.
I got both.
Because I am trying to learn English.
Follow the reference then.
And when people convert to Islam, you don't tell them memorize the Quran in Arabic.
Don't change the point, please.
Don't worry. We'll give you the English, right? Because this time is clarifying to you.
Just come, make your point.
Surah 55, Ayah 68.
Sorry. Fihima fakihatun wa nakhlun wa rumman.
It says, in them are fruits.
Sorry.
And what does it say? No, not time's up.
No, your time's up.
Hatun, don't be unfair.
I told you.
I said.
I told you.
Civilization. Yeah, and he didn't agree to it. He didn't agree to it.
Daniel, you just turned up.
Hatun.
It's my turn.
Hatun.
So, no.
This is really ridiculous. Really ridiculous.
It's not appropriate.
No. It's really ridiculous.
It is amazing that you brought me the verses from the Quran.
Hatun, you are funny, really. You are funny. You make me laugh.
You were quoting that.
If you wanted to answer, you would wait for it. That's ridiculous.
The references you gave, one of them had nothing to do with
it. I haven't finished my reference.
He hasn't finished his point. Come on.
You don't want to learn, do you?
She knows that she's been caught.
That you come with the team and they are just practicing what Islam teaches.
Excuse me.
When I was attacking J. Smith, everybody was attacking me. This my brother was attacking me when I was talking to J. Smith.
They're good students.
They are the same thing.
I had a good point.
That's hypocrisy. Yet they are separated in the Quran.
That's a subjective matter.
I ask you, why do you believe, according to Surah 89 verse 21-23, Allah and angels are two different beings? Allah and angels are two different beings. It is the same grammar. It is the same grammar used in Surah 78-37.
That's your team.
And it is the same grammar. Surah 70 verse 4. Okay? According to Surah 78-38.
Our team.
According to Surah 70 verse 4. Angels and spirit are different. Yet, Quran, according to Surah 2 verse 97 and 98, tells us angels, messengers, Gabriel and Michael are different things. It is the same grammar format.
I didn't do that yet.
It's the same thing you see in Surah 66 verse 4.
What is the point?
According to Quran, which
Arabic
well explained,
has nothing to do with
everything is well detailed, even the verses are well explained, speaks for itself. Angels and spirits are two different beings, and the supporting verse for that comes from the Surah 97 verse 21-23. So, my question is then that, if spirit and angels are different, why?
It wasn't up. We've got 3 seconds left. Go on.
No, go on. Carry on.
You've got 3 seconds.
Make your point.
Look at this.
A lot of time, 3 seconds.
Right. Now, 4 minutes each. Not 2 minutes. No. 4 minutes each.
You said 4 minutes.
4 minutes. 4 minutes each.
2 minutes.
5 minutes each.
2 minutes.
6 minutes
each. Why is it
going
before?
Don't be childish.
You're being childish. You don't understand.
2 minutes.
This is what
we're going to
do. I haven't started.
They can't even
agree. Don't start the clock. 4 minutes.
It's time. He knows that we press that
clock. Okay, then 5 minutes each. If you cut down to two, I'll increase the time.
We're going by heart and soul.
Okay, 2 minutes is too much. You know what? You win because women always win.
5 minutes is too much.
We're going by heart and soul.
How is that racist?
She said 4 minutes, then said 2 minutes. She's changing it.
Right.
First she said 4 minutes.
Okay, now.
Oh, that is all.
So, excuse me, start again because you interrupted, bro. Start again? I didn't say anything.
Okay,
you've got 11 seconds. Good. Bismillah. Now, what am I going to show Amshun now is this. Very quickly, within my 2 minutes, I don't need her to look it up. In the Quran, there's a way of Allah speaking. We call the Arabic construction. If you don't know Arabic, let alone the Quranic Arabic, of course you'll fail to notice this construction of the Arabic language, let alone the Quranic Arabic. So, you have some examples that you quoted earlier. You think somehow they are two different kinds, right? One of them obviously is a different kind. Rabb and Malaika are different. But we have examples within the Quran. For example, Hafizu ala salati wa salatu al-usta. Surah Al-Baqarah 238, where Allah says, God, your prayers and the middle prayer, even though separated, but still of the same kind. Another example, Surah Al-Rahman, Surah 55, verse 68. Fihima faqiyatu wa nakhlu wa rumman. Allah talking about in them are fruits and nakhl and rumman. So you have nakhl and rumman translated as?
Palm and pomegranate.
Palm and pomegranate. Yeah. Of course, palm and pomegranate, both of them are fruits, but they're separated for specific emphasis. You have in another surah, for example, in Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Hajj, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَسْجُدُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ And Allah continues, وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ. So Allah says, come on, don't you not see everything in the heavens and the earth prostrates? And then Allah says, and many of men,
yeah,
when they included in the first category,
they were.
Also, this one is something that you need to understand. When Allah says, وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِن نَبِيِّينَ مِيثَاقَهُمْ وَمِنْكَ وَمِن نُوحٍ, and it continues, when Allah took the covenants from the prophets, and from you, and from Noah, and from other prophets. Are you saying they are not prophets? Because prophets was excluded? I made my point. It's quite obvious. You don't understand Arabic.
Yes.